Miles Morales seemed to be a simple DLC from the start, but ended up being a whole lot more. The game really shows off the PlayStation 5 by being a very big game with 2 second load times. The fact that the fan of the console is near silent while playing this game at a beautiful crisp 60 frames per second is just jaw-dropping for me. Not to mention, the animation in this game is just insane. The people who animate this deserve the Nobel Prize because the way everything moves so fluidly, it's just magical. The web slinging feels less tight due to Miles' bouncing around and doing all kinds of crazy moves, but it doesn't hamper the overall experience. Because it just makes it more fun. It really makes you feel a... Sorry, let me Google something real quick. His exaggerated swagger. Wait. The game moves you through at a brisk pace, only stopping to show you the unbelievable gameplay and story highlights. Unlike the original, there aren't 5 types of crimes per region and a bajillion enemy bases. Instead, the game condenses these to make 4 optional crimes that yield EXP and a small number of enemy bases. But the enthralling sense of the progression from the first game is still there, and it's made even better by nearly every collectible feeling uniquely crafted. Not only do you have missions and side missions, but also app objectives, which have many stories, but are carried out in a more comedic and lighthearted way. There's an app objective where you have to find a cat and track it with dead pizza rats to put it in a bag and swing around to get it back to the owner. At the same time, there's a side mission where you search for a cat named Spider-Man, and it ends up leading you to stopping a bank robbery. You can discover new things about the plot through these side missions, many of which connect into the Spider-Verse movie, which is one of my favorites of all time. There are incredible missions undeniably throughout the entire game, optional or in terms of the story, either way. There are also the caches and time capsules, both of which require many puzzles, combat, or stealth challenges, not even mentioning the samples and postcards, which include puzzles and exploration. The game works hard to ensure it has varied collectibles instead of repetitive ones. The atmosphere of the game is top-notch, where every single area feels alive to the fantastic style. The music would normally hamper the experience due to being a part of a genre that I dislike, but it normally has very good background music or fits the scene so well to the point of it giving me goosebumps. The combat is widely unchanged, but that's not a problem. In my personal opinion, the combat of the first Spider-Man game on PS4 was the best beat-em-up combat of all time, and every flaw here has been fixed. And not only that, but tons of new stuff has been added. The new powers constantly arriving is an idea I absolutely adore. Miles is constantly uncertain of his future and what he can use, and every power feels important and helpful. The electricity can be used for amazing moves that are perfectly integrated into the fluid combat, and the camouflage adds a unique safety net to the stealth. There are many tense scenes in the story, and the narrative actually surprised me. Instead of simply relying on twists or being a very good guy, bad guy story like the original game, it slowly turns the tables of the narrative while still providing grace-based morals. The different warring factions all have different flaws and values. Roxxon has corrupt ideas and mistreats the public, but supports Spider-Man's protection of the city, whereas the Underground does awful attacks on the public while wanting to stop an awful invention that will hurt many. The game actually comes out of nowhere and does great things. Miles is equally doubtful and confident of himself, leading to a lovable character who still makes mistakes. The game builds strong characters due to the fact that Miles doesn't really see himself as the hero, because at the end of the day, he's inspired by those around him, including his mom, his friends, and his community. The characters will constantly do things that you dislike or like, but in the end, everybody realizes what they've done, leading to one of the most amazing final bosses of all time, and one of the greatest stories behind a mission in which war has completely broken out, and it has become the true enemy to all. As it is, in the end, the most dangerous villain Spider-Man faces. Not the Rhino, not Big Wheel, and not Dr. Octopus, but the idea of hatred and war that divides people in the end. The game doesn't hold back anywhere. It's a technical marvel, with great progression, improved combat, an amazing world with fantastic collectibles, good music, and a stellar narrative. The game is simply a masterpiece, and I love it. 5 out of 5.